Starting this week's vlog in a face mask. How attractive. You know, I just had a very inspirational day. I don't know why I'm making so much noise. But at my school, I go to LMU. I'm a theater major. And there was an event with Gloria. I will put a picture up of her. She is the showrunner, like creator and director of One Day at a Time. And she graduated from LMU. And she is goals. She's Cuban. She's awesome. I'm Cuban. Clearly, there was a connection. And she inspired me to work, basically. Be a hustler. Do the thing. Have project after project and stay positive and keep going. So you know what? It's gonna be a freaking bomb-ass weekend. Gonna get things done. So hi, everybody. I'm Jessica Nicole Dickerson, aka Jane D. If you haven't seen any of my videos, and this is the first one you're watching, I'm sorry you have to see this face. I do reading and bookish content. I hope you like. I hope you enjoy. It's Thursday night. I have one class tomorrow from 1 to 4 where I have to do some scenes. She gave us some sides to memorize for class, and we're treating it like an audition. But, you know, it's educational. And I haven't memorized them yet. I'm a bad person, but I'm going to do that tonight. I'm gonna stay up and memorize, but then I also have to wake up at 8 a.m. to register for classes next year. I'm gonna be a senior next year, guys. So excited to be done with school and to start just working on projects more diligently. So drawing, reading, writing, well, you know, and homework and scholarships and all that academia stuff we gotta do. Okay, I might actually start, you know, doing some of them, so. And if you guys were ever wondering when I say I was practicing sides or that I have a scene, they look like this. So this is my email, my school email, and these are what sides look like. And you can like download them and print them out and highlight and annotate as you like. Sorry, the lighting is dreadfully yellow. But yeah. So basically I talk to myself for an hour. That's how I memorize these sides. Like, oh, what a generous offer, Teddy. So, what do you say, Lizzie? We've gotten so busy around here. I was thinking how great it would be if you came back to work. My character's like, yeah, I'm gonna have to pass. I'ma peace out. I'ma talk to myself for hours. And, oh yeah, I'm doing laundry. I almost forgot. Yeah. Many hours have passed. It is now 10 o'clock. I finished my shift at work. It was quite boring and there were so many bugs in the office, like giant mosquitoes. So disgusting. But during my shift, I started how it went down and oh my god. So this is by the same author that wrote The Rock and the River that I read last month. And this was in my library. So I was like, you know, let's check it out. Holy hell, this book is so incredible. So incredible. It's talking way more. I don't even know how to formulate sentences. So this book is basically about a African-American male who got shot by a white person and how the community is dealing with it. And I love it because it's like there are so many characters. And I'm also listening to the audiobook while I physically read because I just like to read like that. So everyone, and it's a full cast for the audiobook, so everyone has a distinct voice. Sometimes I still do get a little confused about which guy is this, because there's a lot of people. We're talking, we hear perspectives from the person who shot him, from the friend who is in the neighborhood who is kind of friends with the shooter, a light-skinned boy who is in the same age group who was kind of involved, a girl who is dating a gang member. Like, we have so many perspectives. It's so incredible. I'm so mind blown. His best friend who wasn't in a gang, who wants to go to college. There's a character junior who is in jail. Like, there's so many perspectives. It's so amazing. And everyone has such interesting perspectives. My favorite perspective is the boy Tyreek who was shot has a best friend, Ty, whose father has the most interesting insight because he's not from the ghetto, or maybe he lived there when he was younger, but now he is, you know, high class. Like, he's like, or is it Sammy's one of the dads, I forget whose dad it is, his name is Steve, has the most interesting commentary that kind of upsets me, but at the same time I understand. He will be like, you can't be friends with Tyreek, he's in a gang, blah, 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 blah. And it's like, dude, maybe he wasn't in a gang. We really don't know. But then at the same time, he talks about how he wants to help his son, and like, it's just crazy hearing everyone's perspectives, because at the same time, the person who shot this boy, even though everything he did was wrong, everything this gentleman did was wrong, you hear his perspective, you hear where he's coming from. There's fear, obviously. I think the problem is that people aren't acknowledging it. If you're scared, you need to fix that shit real quick. Real quick, what are you doing? Walking around this planet scared out of your mind from brown people? It's like, no. And if you don't like it and you're scared of these kids, you need to, you know, these kids are joining gangs because they have nothing to do and their family lives are shit. Like, so if you want to change stuff, you don't want to be scared of these kids who are going to grow up and do bad things, help them. Give them something to do. You know, like, there's solutions, and I just feel like this book has me so heated. And then there's a girl, Jenica, who I want to cradle her. She's my baby because I care for her so much. It's also very interesting because I care for all these characters a lot. Maybe that noodle, because he's fucking up a little bit. There's a lot going on. I have so many feelings. It is so amazing. And I was really scared to pick up this book because I'm like, shit, another book about people being shot, and it's not gonna be worth the hype, and it's not gonna make any commentary. And this book is so much more than the incident. It is about the community. I have like 100 pages left. I'm gonna finish it right freaking now, and I'm gonna tell you all my feelings again. See you dancing there. And you go all night long. And you ain't watching no one else, girl, in your zone. I feel the air ignite. I wanna strike the match. And you ain't with nobody else, girl, let me know. Cause I love the way you are. But you won't let down your guard. And I need you to just, oh. Enough for tonight. I finished it. my turd pillow, my poopy pillow is in the way. Guys, it was so good. What time is it? It's not that late. No, it's like 8 minutes to midnight. It was so good though. Oh my god. All the feels. I love how this book talked about the community, and like, there was a lot of discussion of Tariq and whether he was good or bad. It's like, does that matter? Do the little details matter? This boy is dead. Like, it's crazy. It was so good. It was so, so amazing. I will probably talk about this more, but it was definitely a 5 out of 5. For sure. For sure. I'm like, this is so, I need my own copy now. I'm feeling a lot of feels. Okay. Well, I'm gonna put this away for now. I'm gonna put it out. And I'm gonna start The Love and Lives of Roxanne Ali. Or Roxana Ali. I always say it wrong, I'm so sorry. And maybe get like an hour into this. Give you my love, cause I need you now. I'll give you my all before these candles burning out. I wanna love you, I'm singing aloud. Baby, I'm floating, there's no way I'm coming down. And our hearts beat it in time. Feel like we escaped to paradise. I'll give you my love, cause I need you now. I'll give you my all before these candles burning down. I'll give you my all before.
make it here. We're running out of time, and if you hold my hand, I'll show you how to fly.
Hello. So sorry, I have not been talking a lot. I've been just really enjoying this Saturday. Like, I woke up at like 9:30, ate breakfast, and immediately started reading The Love and Lies of Roxane Ali, which was so amazing. Okay, so I read it all today. Like, I started it last night, but I only read like 30 pages. It was so incredible, so incredible. Like, how I feel about how it went down, where it talks a lot about the community and aspects like that. I feel like so did The Love and Lies. Like, I have no words to express. I like am fangirling so flippin' hard because I feel like, though I loved The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas, I feel like it just introduced a lot of the communal problems but did not resolve them in the way that I wanted. Whereas Roxane Ali, but like things were expressed. The problems she had with her friends, the problems she had with her family. Like, it is what I look for when it comes to diverse contemporary hope and love and the true conflict. And everything was not like just like resolved, like not like a happily ever after kind of thing, but they faced those issues. They talked about it and they faced it, and I loved it. Yes. Haven't really told you what it's about, but that's because I didn't really know much about it going in, and I think you should do the same way. And if you're scared to pick up this book because there's a lot of references to other cultures, I wouldn't be. I am not Bengali. I know nothing of that. And yet I feel like I was immersed into this different culture and I loved it. Which was, I think this is why you should read that. You shouldn't go into a book just because you know the culture. You should actually go into books where you don't know the culture, because that's what reading is about. It's about learning and experiencing something different. So I cannot tell you how much I loved this book and how much I want to rave about it. It was so amazing. And I've been really lucky because How It Went Down and this were both books that I was kind of scared of, but turned out so amazing. It is what I want for my diverse reading. I want to read about different perspectives, and that is exactly what I'm getting. And I'm so happy because it's not a biased, like, judgmental aspect. We are really talking about the nitty-gritty details of people's perspectives. Oh my god, I love it so much. And then, as you saw in my last clip, I started reading The Wicked King, if you can see it. So yeah, start this. I'm literally 10 pages in. I have not many feelings on it yet, but I will let you know as it develops. But I've already fallen behind in my art goals for this month, and it's literally like the 6th of this month. Wow, Jess. I didn't post any art yesterday. I'm gonna try and do some art now and post it. So I'm gonna spend the next hour drawing, still relaxing, then reading. That's the game plan, guys. That's the game plan. I feel like I haven't done anything, even though I've read like 3 books now. I didn't vlog last night because my camera battery died, but I did download House of the Sun volume 4 and 5 because I'm just a little bit hooked on that manga, to be honest. It just leaves great like cliffhangers, and if you don't like manga, you wouldn't like it. But it's basically a story about like this girl who actually the girl and the boy in this story both come from families with complicated backgrounds, and she has left her family, she's still in high school, to live with this boy who has graduated and is now working full-time. So it's a romance and there's an age gap, and she's 17, almost 18, but still, like, if you don't like that, then I can understand. But, like, it's manga, I don't take it personally, and I just like the romance. They don't do anything, it's just that, you know, tension, and I love that. So I feel like, you know, romance books always give you that tension you want. So I love manga for that. So I read the volume 4 and started volume 5 last night. Yeah, I should be doing homework. I have essays to do, I have my taxes to finish, I have emails to do, but, like, art. What's more important, Jess? I have my priorities straight, guys. Yeah, and drawing. I said I'd take like an hour break to draw, but next thing you know, it's like 6 p.m. And it's interesting because I feel like I haven't had a productive weekend, but I have. I've read 2-3 books. Ah, and I think I'm actually gonna finish that manga I was reading last night now, because I have like 70 pages left. So that makes almost 4 books. And then I have The Wicked King to keep reading. But at the same time, I haven't started any of the essays that I have due or projects.
Okay, so this is the one I've been working on. Can you see it? She has cute chitties, and this is her. She's got lots of sass. I kind of got to work on her face. She's a little blown out, and the background matches her skin color a little too much. But we'll work on that. This one, which is okay. Her sweater's cute, but like, it's just okay in my opinion. My favorite is still the one I made last week. This guy, so freaking adorable. Oh, maybe I need to add blush. Okay, maybe that's what she's missing, some blush. Okay, I'll work on her still. I'll do some more work.
But yeah, I guess I'll start procrastinating again. Because I'm going to read that manga instead of doing any of the work that I just said that I should be doing. Because I'm a great student. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this vlog. That'll be it for this weekend. And I'm surprised I did so much. I finished 4 books. I did not finish The Wicked King, though I did start it. I'm 40 pages in, and I'm liking it. I'm waiting for the major plot to start, so we'll see what happens. Stay tuned to next week, yes. But I did finish How It Went Down and The Love and Lies of Roxana Ali, and then volumes 4 and 5 of House of the Sun. And I gave the first 2 5 stars and the second 2 4 stars. So it was pretty good, pretty good. Stay tuned to my wrap up at the end of the month where I'll talk more about them. But yeah, it was a successful weekend. My heart is proud. I hope you guys watching are, you know, getting relaxed and enjoying your time on the weekend and being productive too. So yeah. I don't know what that was. Okay, well, thank you guys so much for watching it. It really means so much to me. I can't believe I'm at 570 subscribers. It's crazy. I wish you all the best, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.